But if you haven't noticed by now, I love Excel and VBA. That's what most of my videos up to this point have been about, and for good reason. We all know Excel by itself is a great tool for engineers, but when we can learn to write code and automate things with VBA, the possibilities become almost endless. This video is just one of those examples. Hey everyone, and welcome back to the Engineering Toolbox channel, where I give you the tools you need to solve real-world engineering problems. So what do we have here? This is a 5S audit form. Some of you may be familiar with 5S. It's a housekeeping methodology used for keeping work areas clean and organized and standardized and all that good stuff. More on that in other videos. But a common part of 5S programs is to have regular audits of work areas so the results of the program can be measured and maintained. This is a form for doing those audits, but kind of with a twist. So first, let's go through this form here. At the top, we kind of have like a header here where you can select from a list of different auditors. You enter in your audit date, and you select a department where you're gonna be doing the audit. Let's say we're doing it in the machining department. And what's cool is we have dependent lists here. So when I select machining, the zones within machining, there's only three of them. If I were to select fabricating, it shows that there's more zones in fabrication. So this list depends on this list. So that's kind of a cool little feature. And then we can also select from a list of shifts that we'll be doing the audit on. So then as we go down, we can see our different kind of categories here. So again, if you're familiar, there's sort, set and order, shine, standardize, and sustain. Those are the five different steps or categories used in the 5S methodology. Okay, let's go through an example to show how I've taken a simple form and turned it into something really awesome using VBA. So if we're going through this area and we're auditing it, we found, let's say, an extra wrench, just as an example. And let's say there is some oil on the floor in the shine category. We give it an 8 in the sustain category. And we can see that it gives us this total down here, shows us the number of violations for each category, shows us the scores then, and then the total average score. So now here's the really cool part. If I hit log audit data, it gives us different actions. So we can create a PDF of our form here. We can log the data so we can record these values into like a historical spreadsheet. We can clear the form to start over and add a new one or something like that. We can actually send a confirmation email, maybe to a supervisor or something like that, to say that, hey, this has been completed, and then we can close the form. So I'm gonna uncheck clear form and close form just to show what these three checkboxes do. I hit okay, the code runs, and what that's done is it's actually created that PDF. So if I go out here and that up in the directory that it saved it to, you can see, and there's my email notification to let me know that I just got that email that Paul Malov has created their completed their 5S audit. So there's the PDF. We'll click on the email to see that. And here's the email. It automatically generates this. So I added a little note. This email is automatically generated. Paul Malov created or completed their audit of zone F2. And then it attaches the PDF. So if I click on that, we can open it and see the PDF attached in the email too. So then one last thing, since we had the log data checked as well, we can go to our 5S program spreadsheet where we keep the historical data, open that up. And when we go down to the bottom of the list, we can see that it added the data from our form right into this historical spreadsheet along with all the other data from the other audits. Then we can do some cool things like pivot tables and look at different months and see what the scores were like, maybe look at a timeline, that type of thing. So as you can see with VBA, we were able to do a lot of really cool things very easily. We created a PDF, log data into another spreadsheet, and sent an email notification all with the click of a button. If you thought this was cool, make sure to hit that like button and comment below with your thoughts. If I get enough likes, I'll do a tutorial series on how to actually create this spreadsheet from scratch. Then of course, make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss those tutorials or any of the other great videos that I'm posting every week. Remember, this channel is for you. It's meant to equip you with the tools to be the best engineer you can be. So if there's anything you want me to cover, be sure to drop me a comment and let me know what you want to see. Thanks for watching.